Things, I'm your friend, Dr. Charles Apoki. The things happening in this country are no longer funny. No longer funny. No longer funny. The Bible says, honor your father and your mother, that your days may be long and may be well with you. But the next verse, the Bible says, do not, parents, do not exasperate your children. There is a video that is trending of a little girl struggling palliative or noodles with an auntie. She said, give me my palliative. Give me my palliative. Give me my palliative. And then she wanted to cry before the thing was handed over to her. The person recording the video found it funny. But frankly speaking, it's a true representation of the state of this country. To be exasperated is to be angry, frustrated, and have a sense of hopelessness and helplessness. I was watching a train that stopped in the middle of nowhere at night along the Abuja-Kaduna Express, railway line. A den of terrorists. Trains have been shot out there before. These are trains we borrowed money from China to buy. Rotimi Amechi, you borrowed money from China to buy this plane, trains. And then these trains are breaking down. I saw one that broke down in the middle of nowhere. And prominent citizens of this country, and most probably of northern extraction too, because I just talked about the killing in the north, we're in the middle of nowhere, unprotected. And you can imagine the desperation. The one that stopped at night, I saw people shouting, angry, and the wicked people operating the train locked the door against themselves. They were not offering any explanation. There was no rescue mission. There was nothing. People left in the middle of nowhere. Midnight. What is wrong? Then Amechi, I saw somewhere that he wants to return the train. Did you inspect the train? Who even made you minister for transportation? What does Amechi know about transportation? The train that you left in Port Harcourt, hanging in the middle of the air, could you complete it? Why must we celebrate rubbish and incompetence in this country? How long will the citizens of this great nation suffer before somebody will do something? If it is in decent societies, Amechi will have been sacked, removed from office. How can we play a match with a regularly losing team, a team that is insensitive to the needs of this country? Amechi, whoever that is in position of authority, those trains, return them and tell the Chinese we don't want them. We can't borrow our money and buy nonsense. If Nigeria PLC were to be your company, will you manage it like that? And you people want to borrow more money from other nations and bring sub-quality products to us and substandard products to us. And then the rubbish attitude you have towards life and the value for your citizens, you will continue with it. I'm very angry. And most Nigerians are angrier than I am. And one other thing that is exasperating the nation is that how can fathers be telling lies in public, be telling lies in panel setup? We were not there. We were there. We shot plastic bullets. We didn't shoot plastic bullets. It was soldiers and thugs that wore army uniform. Somebody went to look for camera. You are too old. Those of us, my age bracket that is ruling this nation, we are too old to behave like stupid and wicked parents. Our children are angry. And when this thing will burst, very few people will be spared. I'm saying my own now so that people will know I'm not part of the wickedness. God bless Nigeria. God will bring real change to this nation. We cannot continue like that. God bless you.